I am an African. I owe my being to the hills and the valleys, the mountains and the glades, the rivers, the deserts.
We need to have proper schools. I'm surprised that after 22 years, students have to go to the streets and say we want free education. This is sad. South Africa should know that to free South Africa is through education.
My body has frozen in our frosts and in our latter-day snows. It has thawed in the warmth of our sunshine and melted in the heat of the midday sun.
You know, so every day when you wake up, take yourself with you. You are an African, but man,
but something in me also makes it very difficult to just say yes, because I'm also disappointed with Africa. I'm tired with Africa. I'm struggling with my faith in Africa. I'm looking at Africa and I see too much of the same picture. I'm waking up to too much of the same dominance, the same imbalance, the same leadership, corruption. I'm tired of it. So I cannot just say, yeah, I'm proud to be African. It sounds good.
The crack and the rumble of the summer thunder, lashed by startling lightning, have been a cause both of trembling and of hope.
So the African Youth Charter, it's a framework that describes youth rights and duties. It's supposed to guide governments.
Basically, SOTU is a multi-sectoral coalition across the entire continent in Africa, but it's basically for 10 countries in the moment. And we are trying to hold African governments accountable to the promises that they make. This is a very serious, important issue. And I want to tell you something. The question I'll say to you is, what does it mean to be African to you? And take that answer. And realize that African.
A human presence among all of these, a feature on the face of our native land just defined, I know that none dare challenge me when I say I am an African.
That when you engage with the oppressor in the round table, you are going to reach a consensus. That's the nature of politics. And you will compromise critical things as Africans. Like, for example, we are speaking in English, not because we want to, but it's because we're taught English. You see, I cannot express my political views or my academic views using my own mother tongue because of the system of education. And that is as a result of accepting to uproot a system which was entrenched through violence by peaceful means. Like now we are saying we are Africans, we have to ask, what is this animal called Africa? First of all, it's not an African name. The name Africa is not an African name. So it's confusing for you to stand there with your Afro hair and say that.
Africa, and you must be able to make money out of Africa. The content of the curriculum, especially institutions of higher learning, is more westernized. You are not told about, you are being brainwashed, you are not being told of how rich Africa it is.
I am formed of the migrants who left Europe to find a new home on our native land. Whatever their own actions, they remain still part of me. In my veins courses the blood of the Malay slaves who came from the East. Their proud dignity informs my bearing, their culture a part of my essence. The stripes they bore on their bodies from the left of the slave was.
My name is Baba Buntu and I was invited here as a presenter, and I'm really happy that I was able to meet with so many vibrant students. I think the dialogue today went well. We had good questions, good comments. I think the only frustration is that we always realize that African questions are complex and it's not something we can discuss in just a few minutes. So I hope to get an opportunity to meet with some of the students again and go deeper into the analysis and also the practical aspects of what African identity, African culture, African history means. We are an incredible people, although we feature in this world as if we're only known for weakness and being in a marginal existence. And I think for me it's very important to remind young people that they are the solutions for Africa's tomorrow. And I know that they can be if they position themselves as proud proud Africans who are willing to read, willing to study their history, and willing to devote themselves for the future of this continent. So I'm happy that I was able to come here, and I look forward to engagements in the future. Thank you very much.